Hi everyone, very good morning to all the viewers. At the outset, once again I welcome you all to this BBIMS Dr. R.M. Malle Hospital. Formerly it was known as PGIMR or Postgraduate Institute of Medical Education and Research. It implies that your study or course will be not completed unless you do some research work. So research is the need of this time. As you know, whole world is waiting desperately for the corona vaccine by research only. So what is research? Research is the a careful investigation or inquiry, especially through search for new fact in any branch of knowledge, or other way also can define it is a systematized effort to gain new knowledge. So what makes people to undertake research? So what is the motivation under research? To get a research degree along with its consequential benefit, face the challenges in solving unsolved problem like this corona that everybody is trying to prepare the corona vaccine for whole world, and to get intellectual joy of doing some creative work and be serviced to the society and to get respectability. Whatever research done so far, it is the tip of the iceberg only. So many things are left for you to do the research work. Again, the Postgraduate Medical Education Regulation 2000 of NCIE has given the direction and guideline for the MDMS student that MDMS student examination in any subject of subject shall consist of theory paper, thesis, clinical, practical and oral examination. The thesis paper, every candidate shall carry out work on assigned research project under the guidance of recognized postgraduate teacher, the result of which shall be written off and submitted in the form of thesis. This work for writing the thesis is aimed at contributing to the development of spirit of inquiry, technique of research, critical analysis, acquaintance with the latest advance in medical science, and identifying and consult available literature. Thesis shall be submitted at least 6 months before the theoretical or clinical or practical examination. A candidate shall be allowed to appear in university exam only after acceptance of thesis by the examiner. The following subclause is added after clause 13.8c in term of gazette notification in 9th December 2009. That 13.9 subclause denotes that a PG or postgraduate degree course in broad specialty and super specialty would be required to present. This is now mandatory that one candidate or one student should present one poster or to read one paper at national and state level conference and to present one research paper which should be published, accepted for publication or sent for publication. Above are the eligibility criteria to appear the postgraduate degree examination. The following subclause is added after clause 13.9 in term of a gazette on notification dated 11th December 2019 that 13.10 that subclause indicates that all PG shall complete an online course of a research method, that is the basic course in biomedical research, that is online course, that is mandatory now for the PG student to appear the degree examination. This notification of MCIE gazette notification came on 11th of December 2009, on which that online research methods course is mandatory and compulsory for all PG student. These are the MCIE notification. The medical postgraduate, that is on 11th December 2019, and for medical teachers, it is 12th February 2020. For this basic course in biomedical research, if you put in the Google, this window will come about this biomedical research on online course. This course indicates that in order to improve the research skill of Indian medical postgraduate and teachers in medical institution, that MCI has mandated a uniform research methodology course. This online course is a basic course in biomedical research, which will be offered by ICMR, National Institute of Epidemiology, Chennai. This is the online address. And the course explains the fundamental concept of research methodology in health. It will be delivered through video lecture and reading material. Certification will be done based on lecture-wise assignment and a final proctored exam. This meant for the student or the audience, those include that medical postgraduate MDMS who have joined during the academic year 2019 and 2020, teachers in the medical institution, and this is supported by or approved by Board of Governance of NCI. Already two cycle already over, now it is the time for the third cycle, which is from August 2020 to November 2020. The basic course of biomedical research cycle 3, which include that the course is include 23 lecture covering conceptualization of research study, which include epidemiological and biostatistical consideration in designing research study, planning and conducting research study, writing research protocol and publication ethics. The learning material include video lecture, presentation slide, example accompaniment, and reading material and assignment. The summary for the third cycle is that the course already started, is going on now, that duration is 16 weeks, that started from 20th August 2020, it will end by 20th December 2020. The enrollment started from 20th, enrollment will be over by 20th November 2020, and this is a postgraduate level research. And regarding this summary or this flow chart for this research study, there are mainly three things are there. One is the enrollment process, one is course process, and next is final examination. So first you have to enroll, then you have to access the assignment, and you have to submit the assignment. If you have submitted the assignment, if you secure more than 50%, or then you have to appear and register for the final examination. If you pass in the final examination more than 50% of the mark, then you will get the e-certificate. If not, otherwise you will, if secure less than 50%, then you are not eligible to appear for the final examination. Again, you have to re-registration and you have to repeat all the process. If you pass the final examination, then you are eligible for the certificate, which certificate will be signed by the Secretary of NCI and the Director of National Institute of Epidemiology. Again, our IP University also gave the direction and guideline for MDMS student that include, and one student should know the basic concept of research and research methodology, be able to plan a research project, should know how to consult resources in the library, and you should know how to use the internet, and you should have the basic knowledge of statistics if it is required, and also issued the guideline by the IP University for writing the thesis and thesis protocol. This is the first page of this guideline. Already that full PDF guideline have given to the first year medicine PG student. All PG student should collect from the medicine first year PG student and go through it in detail. So next is the stages in research process. That first is you have to define the problem. Then you have to plan the protocol, or that is design. then planning a sample, then gathering the data, then you have to process the and analyze the data. Final stage is you have to formulate the recommendation and summary, then conclusion. These are the different stages of research process. Then come to protocol. The word protocol comes from the Greek word protocolon, meaning a leaf of paper glued to a manuscript volume that describes the content. Then what is the thesis protocol? This is a thesis protocol is a document designed by a panel of experts and adherence by a study investigator. And the protocol describes that scientific rationale of the objective, design, methodology, statistical consideration, and organization of planned trial. And the protocol contains precise study plan for executing clinical trial or research. So that's about the protocol. Then next we'll go to format of a protocol. So what is the format of a protocol? This is the full format, starting from title page to the annexure. So you have to put this one in the different heading and which page you have kept this. Then the format of a protocol, it should around 10 to 12 copies would be there, 4 copies for the PG student, 4 copies for the registered office, ABBIMS, A4 size paper should be there, margin at least 2.5 centimeter, there is a double spacing there, and alignment should be in justified and one side of the paper. New page for each section, only one side sheet should be used, and binding should be spiral, which is simplest and easy to do that spiral binding. Next is the title page. You have to mention these are the you should cover this thing in the title page or cover page, and to write the details of this thing. And this is the format or format for the this title page, which include that year of degree. Then you have to put the logo. Then you have to mention the university name, then which year to which year, then the study title, then a candidate name, department, and institute name. Next is the supervisor page. This should include this thing in the supervisor page, and this is a format for the supervisor page, which include titles of the thesis, name of the institution, name of the supervisor, the signature co-supervisor, and signature of the co-supervisor. Then you have to give the undertaking. This should be included under undertaking. Around 19 points are there. Lastly, should sign by the supervisor and the candidate. Then you have to submit the declaration from the candidate. Should sign by the candidate and declaration from the supervisor. Then certificate from the HOD, which is to be signed by head of the department or HOD. Then that index of the protocol, and these things should be included under protocol with page number. Then introduction, what is this, why you are doing the research on that topic, on protocol introduction, you have to include those things. There should not be more than 20 lines. Then review literature, you have to write review literature, you have to mention the previous what research has done or study have done on this heading. Then you have to mention lacuning of existing knowledge. Then research question and hypothesis is also very important. Then aims and objective. The aim of your study should be briefly stated, seldom number more than 3. Don't include aims which your study cannot provide the result. And the aims of the study should be precise, clear, and carefully stated. Then it comes to the material method, that you have to specify the study place, specify the study design, duration, then define the study subject, inclusion, exclusion, and then outcome measures, detailed study, flowchart, etc. Then next to the statistical method, you have to explain how do you employ them to analyze, to obtain the results. Next is the reference, you have to mention the reference. These all these things in details, the subsequent speaker will mention about all these things in details. So next annexure that includes pro forma, consent form, patient information sheet that should be bilingual in Hindi and English. So that's all about the format. Then slide which to be presented in IRB meeting. This also most important. You should not present all the slide, only some important specific slide to be shown in IRB meeting, that Institute Review Board Committee. This include that title page you have to show, then you have to show the title only title you have to mention, nothing else in this page. Then this supervisor page you have to mention, then introduction you have to write, then research question, hypothesis, aim objective, followed by material methods, then statistical methods. That's all, but you have to keep this slide, review literature and lacuna existing knowledge and reference after thank you slide, because anytime any IRB committee member can ask for this. Okay, so that's all. Any question, queries are invited, you can ask or you can